Welcome to the Blazor Smart Paste Button Component Tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Smart Paste Button Component. With AI-powered functionality in Syncfusion's Button Component, you can paste data directly into forms with just one click. This button simplifies form filling and ensures that everything is formatted correctly. Before proceeding, ensure that you have the .NET 8 SDK and Visual Studio 2022 installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the Blazor web application, then provide the project name. I am using .NET 8 as the framework for this project, and I changed the mode to Interactive Server, because this component are fully compatible with server interactivity mode apps. To learn more about interactive render modes, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. I'll continue the project creation with the global interactivity location. When I click the Create button, the project creation will start. Now the application is ready to use. Next, let me proceed to add the Blazor Smart Paste Button component. First, I need to install the NuGet package in my application. So, open the NuGet Package Manager, switch to the Browse tab, search for the Syncfusion Blazor Smart Components package, and install the latest version. I also install the Themes NuGet package to include the CSS and script files. After installation, navigate to the Imports Razor file and add the Syncfusion Blazor Smart Components namespace. This is used to implement the component in the Pages folder. Next, I open the program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then I register the Syncfusion Blazor service to use the Smart Paste Button component. Next, I need to connect the application to an AI service using the provided credentials, allowing the component to analyze data intelligently based on AI predictions. To do this, I first declare a string variable named API key. This is a secret key provided by the AI service to authorize requests. Next, I declare a string variable named deployment name, which refers to the name of the deployment where the AI model is running. Finally, I declare the endpoint variable, which represents the base URL of the AI service used to send inference requests. These strings represent the essential credentials required to connect to the AI service provided by the Azure OpenAI service. If you want to know how to obtain the API key, deployment name, and endpoint, check the documentation link provided in the description below. After that, I import the Syncfusion Blazor Smart Components namespace. This namespace used to register AI services. Then, I register the Syncfusion Smart Components services with the Blazor app's dependency injection system. This ensures that the necessary services for AI-enhanced functionality, like the Smart Paste button, are available throughout the app. After that, I configure the credentials required to interact with the AI service. The AI service credentials object is initialized with the API key, deployment name, and endpoint values, allowing Syncfusion smart components, such as the Smart Paste button, to connect and communicate with the AI service for inference. Finally, I inject the OpenAI inference capabilities into the Syncfusion Smart Components. This enables features like the Smart Paste button to leverage AI to enhance user interactions, such as automatic data completion or suggestions. Next, I navigate to the AppRazor component, host the script, and refer to the CSS for the component. Here, everything is configured. So, open the Home Razor component. Remove the default code. Now I will show you how to create a bug tracking form using the Syncfusion Blazor Data Form component. Usually, details of the bug are manually added to the form. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use the Smart Paste button to efficiently fill in the bug form, streamline data entry, and reduce errors. To do this, I define the Syncfusion Data Form component with form items for the bug fields. I also set up the form validator to apply validation logic, ensuring that the form data meets the required criteria before submission. If you want to learn how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Data Form component in a Blazor application, check out the video link provided in the description below. When I run the example application, you'll see that the data form is displayed in the correct layout. I'm manually entering the bug details can take a lot of time and may lead to mistakes. If I try to submit the form without filling in the fields, a validation message appears. To make filling out this form easier, I'll show you how to use the Smart Paste Button component. To implement this, I define a Form Buttons tag. This tag creates the buttons at the bottom of the form to submit your information. Inside this tag, I define the Syncfusion Smart Paste Button tag, which automatically fills form fields using clipboard data. I set the isPrimary property to true, making this the primary button in the form. I also add the content property, which specifies the text inside the button. Additionally, I set the icon CSS property to define the icon for the button. Looking here, the data form is rendered with the Smart Paste button. When I copy the bug report details from an external source, like a Word document, and click the Submit button, notice that all the fields are automatically filled in the form. Now let me summarize. I've shown you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Smart Paste Button component and demonstrated how to create a bug tracking form using the Syncfusion Blazor Data Form component. I also walked through the implementation of the Smart Paste Button component in Data Form. If you want to see the working code for this example, you can download it from that GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to check if you qualify for a free community license to access all our Blazor components. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.